academia. I absolutely love to text. And I'm only 11. But I've been looking into texting, into the depth of texting over these couple of months. Texting, texting, texting. Seems good, seems bad. Have you ever saw two people sitting next to each other, both on their phones, but they're not communicating to each other? Those sorts of things get me upset. When you could be having a new friend laughing together, but their heads are just on the phone. But you're trying to get someone's attention. It could be the most important thing in the world. But they will look right up into your face and say, "What did you say?" And then the bad thing will happen, and then they will say, "Why didn't you tell me?" "Well, excuse me, you were on your phone." There might be bad things with texting, but there are some good things about texting. If you have a family member who has lost another family member, you could go call them instead of texting, so you have a heart-to-heart conversation. There's another situation when someone has lost their voice, so they can't talk to you. You could just text them and find out what they need and want. It is also good when someone is in a different country to you. You can just video call them for free. This is good because you can do it every day, and without using your money to fly over there, you can just video call. Even though you can still go over there, you can save your money and use it on useful things and donate to charity. Wow, I'm surprised texting turned out good. But let's go to the main part. Does anyone really talk anymore when text, messages, and emails? Do you really talk anymore?
In my opinion, this genetic technology
energy could be used for something useful, like genetically creating organs for people who are ill, or maybe even time travel. In this situation, I think that technology is being used for the wrong reason. These dogs never get to stretch their legs thanks to their owners. Think about it. When people say, "She's so cute," they're actually saying it to the owner. These dogs don't have the same opportunities as other dogs, like being able to walk freely, sniff things, and generally going for a walk. They may be going outside, but they're not walking. When you see a dog on a lead, you think, there's a happy pet getting some exercise. When you see a dog in a handbag, you think, wow, that's horrible, it should be treated differently. Or do you think, wow, she's so amazing. What kind of person are you? I know what I would think. Dogs' lives are not meant to be spent sitting around in handbags. The genetic technology used to make toy-sized dogs could be better used solving real problems. Is your dog not fitting into your handbag a real problem? Let dogs be dogs, not fashion items. Thank you.
Also, people think emojis are killing the English language, but it ain't. And emojis are a quicker way of writing. And emojis will always help me, even in the future. For example, if I was going ice skating, I won't put an elephant emoji. But emojis are funny, but when it comes to the time, it isn't.
I'm telling you about emoji. What are emojis? Now I understand emojis are to help. Like, imagine I wrote a message to my friend and I put an emoji. And, yeah. Emojis make text messages look fun, but why else do you use them? We can then help you express things we can with writing. Why not?
Greenside Primary School in London. Technology. We've come so far in this wonder of inventions. One of our many creations in this world has been prosthetic limbs and body parts. If you know or have ever met anyone with a body malfunction, and if they have a prosthetic body part, you will know what possibilities it has created. Before this technology, people couldn't do the things they loved. Swim, jump, dance, much more. But scientists have created artificial body parts, and now we have the ideas and tech to manufacture them to fit a certain human being. They've transformed the lives of many people, and scientists were the beacon of light in the darkness to whose lives they have revolutionised. Today I'm going to talk to you about how prosthetics have changed the world we live in today. One of our biggest achievements was forming the Paralympics, and I will also speak about this part of simulated body parts. We will explore how tech has reborn the lives of athletes, from not being able to walk to becoming a champion in front of millions and millions of people. So, what amazing and spectacular things have humans accomplished due to the outstanding inventions of prosthetics? Have you seen any of the Paralympic adverts? The Paralympians have risen from the bottom and are now an inspiration to the world. These people are superhumans and have overcome whatever obstacles are thrown at them. Without prosthetic tech, the superhumans wouldn't have been able to get where they are today. They've been able to live like everyone else. Their only difference is that they are incredibly unique. And no matter what they look like, it is the inside that counts. Artificial limbs have created endless opportunities to the world's inspirations. If you want proof what wonders this tech is doing, take a look at Johnny Peacock, a very talented young man who has risen to the top with artificial body parts helping him along the way. Without tech, he wouldn't be the champion he is today. At the age of 5, Johnny contracted meningitis. Luckily, he survived the disease, but it killed the right tissue in his right leg. Because of this, his leg had to be amputated below the knee. So, now can you see how much this invention has done and is doing to people like Peacock? Now we have the power to mend people's lives and produce champions. We've come so far with prosthetics, and with years to come, who knows what wonderful things we will be able to produce. Soon, hopefully, we'll be able to probably make real-life legs, and the possibilities are endless with the rate that technology is growing. We've transformed the lives of people who have lost limbs. So, I ask you, whose lives will we revolutionise next? Thank you.
Emojis are good because they help me feel.
Action.
Hi, my name is Marty and today I'm going to be talking to you about texting rather than talking. I think that people should stop texting because maybe they might have to talk to someone, which is really important. I absolutely love texting. Have you seen people in cafes or buses sitting down and not even talking to each other? All they're just doing is just texting, texting, texting. One day I was sitting next to my grandma and all she was doing was just texting and not even talking. They just went stop. In my opinion, I think people shouldn't text because it is more easier to talk instead of moving and touching loads of buttons. If you've got in trouble, you don't have to call your parents. You could just talk. Some people or you love friends, but all I'm saying is that why can't you talk to a person next to you? It's like emails and text messages are taking over the world. I've seen so many people talking to no one and just texting.
They're soon going to end up in dictionaries. Maybe soon there might even not be any proper way to say a word. They cannot get past that point. This is my only chance. This is your only chance. This is our only chance. Please, save the language.
Emojis. If you have a birthday, you can send a emoji present. But are they important? But are they just fun pictures? Understands what emojis mean. Or you could work it out what like
language. Is texting killing the English language? I don't think texting is killing the English language, because they are really cool. They're just adding on to the language by shortening words with abbreviations. I think text messages are amazing. If anything, text messages are just making the English language better. I don't know about you, but I think you have to be pretty smart to understand something like BTW or CULATR. Text messages. What's next, I ask you? Thank you and goodbye.
Bye.
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 Somebody far away if you need them urgently, and there won't be a point to go to the other side of the world if you need them urgently. The benefits are seeing someone grow, and it makes your family a bit more together. It is good because you can express your feelings, and it is like you're actually in front of the person. It is also good to have Skype because it is fun to see someone you can't meet in your local area. Skype helps you see someone important you might need. It's also fun to see someone you love. Why do you think Skype's good? It is good, for example, if you had a friend in America and you lived in India, it would be good to Skype them every now and then. We spoke to Mr. Groves and we asked him some questions. One of the questions were, why is it important to Skype? He answered, it is important to see my family every now and then. So, do you think Skype is something you need? I'll leave you with these questions.
Hi, my name is Dixon, and I'm going to talk to you about how technology has given people their life back. Don't you think that it is amazing that technology has actually helped people who used to think that they could do nothing, but now, because of one of the most amazing inventions, prosthetics, they are now up and running. I would like to draw your attention to the fact that Johnny Peacock, who lost his leg at the age of 5, and now, because of technology, he is now 1.9 seconds behind Usain Bolt. Isn't that amazing? I think that Johnny Peacock is an inspirational guy, and he has shown us that we can do anything if we want. I hope I've given you an idea about how amazing technology is, and I'm going to leave you with a question. Will you be able to transform someone's life one day? I hope so. Thank you.
Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1, action.
Hello, my name is Leslie.
I've been wondering about emojis. What are emojis? I think emojis are shorter for writing. I have one thing to tell you. No, two. First one. Do good things on your
phone.
On your phone. Number two, don't do silly things or you'll block up your phone and wouldn't have a phone.
My name is Azeem. I think that Skype is good because you can speak to your family and friends. Your parents will be very happy that you have Skyped them because they haven't seen you for a month or more. And they will miss you and how you look. That means that you can nearly see your parents' faces every single day, which is important when you're older. You don't see them every day anymore.
Hi, my name is Abir, and I'm going to tell you all about it. I think emojis are good because if someone sends you something sad, bad or mad, you just send them an emoji to show you understand how they feel. The first time I saw Mum sent an emoji to her friend, I didn't know what it was. If I tell my friends to have a race, then and I use emojis, they know it's going to be awesome because of the emojis.
My name is Abdurrahi. I am a bit sad about it, but I know someone that has reached stop cyberbullying because it is bad for children. But you need rules. Don't write in comments. Tell the teacher. You don't tell your mum and dad or a teacher. People shouldn't be sending it. Because it is upset and unfair for
action.
Hi, my name is Primrose and I'm here to tell you that technology gives people their lives back. People in the Paralympics are heroes, such as Edison wins for swimming, and so technology gives people a chance to be like everybody else in their everyday life. A quote from the Paralympics is, it's not what's missing, it's what's there. It inspired me to realise that technology can help someone in so many different ways. For example, when you die, you can save someone from any age, and even though you're dead, you can save someone. Will you donate your organs? When I'm older, I will definitely donate my organs, because I could save so many people's lives. The people, the people must be very brave, such as Johnny Peacock. He lost his leg when he was just a boy. He thought he'd never recover. But look at him now. I heard that when he was a boy, he used to get teased about not having a leg. Well, thanks to technology, Johnny Peacock is 1.9 seconds behind Usain Bolt. In 100 years, I think he would need to donate to organs, because technology will be so clever and helpful. They could just make them and sell them at your local Sainsbury's. We've got the technology to give people their lives back, but we also need you. How will you help?
Emojis are for text messages, and instead of messaging, you can use their emojis. Emojis help you to get your friend to what you mean. Emojis are great because they are really helpful. Emojis are helping us for doing some helpful things. Emojis are great. Emojis help you with something else as well. They help you help other people that are a different language get what you mean. Something happens that is sad, add it to a sad emoji. Emojis, what are they for?
Skip.
go.
Hi, my name is Sonia.
And my name's Una. I think emojis are really important because if you don't know how to write, you can put an emoji picture to explain what you mean, even though I'm a very good writer.
I like emojis because they explain how are you feeling. There's lots of types of emoji faces. If your birthday is today, you send a birthday cake. I think they are more than just pictures.
Hi, my name is Anaya. I'm here today to talk about how text messages are killing the English language. But in my opinion, I think it is just a different way of speaking in our English language. Other people think it just spoils our language. I think it's good because if somebody's having an argument, they can just say the bad words in a shorter way. People think it is really, really hard to read and they don't understand. But sometimes it is confusing. Somebody might know how to spell it and so might you, but they will think they are dumb because they don't understand. It can also be mean sometimes because the person that you're sending a message to, they might think that you have no time. People are okay with contracting words like don't, but why aren't they okay with words like C-U-L-8-R? Are you okay with words like C-U-L-8-R? I think they are okay because it can be easier to write if you're in a rush. So what do you think? Do you like long words or short words? So I'll leave that question with you.
Hello, my name is Elodie and I'm here talking about our messages killing the English language. People are making words more difficult for other people to read other people's new language. Rather than you texting someone, than phoning someone having a really long chat, and you just having a little chat and waiting for other people to respond. I would text my friends and family if something was really important and had happened. I would text them, but if it wasn't important, I wouldn't text them, but I don't use text talk. But if something really bad had happened, like your friend or member of family had a car crash and they MSG'd you and you didn't understand what they said and it's really important. Say today it's your mum's birthday and you said H-A-P-Y B-Day. Your mum wouldn't think you meant it. And then you said to your sister, like a proper I and M-S-W, meaning I miss you, but in shorter words. And she would think that you didn't mean it at all. Sometimes it is really confusing to read and write and spell shorter words as text talk. Thank you.